Okay, I was asked by a couple people to do some more like canned fish videos. I hadn't done one in quite a while, but I think I did one video a while back where I showed some of the newer ones that I had found, but I think I did some of them, but like this was one of them, I believe. There's a couple other ones that I had and I didn't do videos on them, but I have to find them again. I'm starting to run out of new ones around here, I'll have to check Walmart again, but I think they might have a couple that I haven't done. But I think there's a couple, like one other version of this one that I haven't had. This is the tomato and basil. So and there's a like a smoked or whatever the other one is. But, because normally I'm not big on tomato sauce, sardines, but, I don't know, we'll see what it tastes like. I've had these for a while, they're good till 2024, but I think I've had this can for a year or something, but, anyway, so we'll do a, give it a try and see what it's like. Packaging. Maybe I'll read the ingredients for you. Let's see. So it's sardine fillets, water, tomato paste, soy oil, modified cornstarch, salt, sugar, spice, citric acid, paprika extract, xanthan gum, sodium carbonate, polysorbonate 80, made in Canada. Cloverleaf Seafood Corporation, Black's Harbor, New Brunswick. There you go. That's all the information you probably need. So it's a normal, flat, kind of kipper snack kind of can. Just leave that there. Make a big mess. You can see the fish and the tomato and the basil in there. Looks alright. Yeah, it doesn't. It smells fishy with a really tiny bit of sort of tomato kind of smell. Maybe a hint of the basil. I'm getting it. It's not that strong, but that's probably a good thing, because sometimes when they put stuff in canned fish or whatever, and they just overpowers things. Like when it's just sort of like a little subtle, sort of like that, the ones with like lime sauce or whatever the other one was, that had a little hint of it, but it wasn't super overpowering. So fish is really soft. I can get a hold of some here. Alright. I don't have any crackers. I gotta go to the dollar store and get some, but yeah, I don't know. You get the tomato, but it's kind of, I don't know, like it's not as sweet. It doesn't really seem like a sweet tomato sauce. I don't know. It kind of it sort of tastes like what you would think it would taste like when you take tomato paste, mix it with like soy oil, and throw a little bit of basil in with it. It's sort of, I don't know. It's not really. Yeah. Yeah, I think it sort of tastes like the tomato paste you get like in the little small cans, like this, but like the super cheapest kind you can get, kind of, or I'm not sure if it is or not, but it's sort of, you get that kind of impression that it's not great, but it's not like enough flavor that it's offensive, but it's kind of like it's sort of like, why? Like, why is it there? Like, it doesn't really seem to... I don't know. That's not overly sweet or anything, which I don't know, if you took, like, normal, like, these kippers and then just put, like, dumped Heinz ketchup on it, which is quite sweet. Like, I don't know if that would be good either. Like, that almost sounds like it would be gross. It's kind of like when you have, like, really cheap beer that has that kind of weird sweetness, kind of like apple juice weird sweetness to it, and it's just, like, disgusting. So it's good that this is sort of not sweet, because I think that would be kind of gross, but... So for me, they're okay. Like, they're not the worst tomato ones I've had, but I don't know. Like, they're like way, like, for me, they're way down the list. Like, their hot sauce one is better. Their smoked one, what the hell is that one called? Anyway, it's like the smoked one they make. The lemon pepper one is better. The regular ones are better. This is pretty much, I think this is probably the farthest one down, like. But, but it's okay. It's just, the tomato just doesn't seem to, just not doing it for me. But, but you know. But I don't really. I was never big on the tomato sardines or whatever, and the mustard sauce ones are fairly low down, but it just seems like they're not well executed. Like, there's probably other brands where it just seems like the flavors sort of complement each other. These ones, they it's just there. But, the oil almost seems like it's kind of taken away from the tomato. It makes the, sort of waters the, I don't know, it's kind of like when you have, like, a little bit left in the tomato bottle and you put water in it to get that last little bit, which to me is, like, disgusting. So it's, I don't know, it's kind of getting in that territory, I think. But, yeah, we're okay, I guess. I think they're far from the worst, or far from the best ones, so. Anyway, thanks for watching, and we will talk to you later.